All right, here we go. Sorry, some technical difficulties. We have Arma and Dan top, Harkonnen and Harkonnen against Kip, Atreides, and Shao Harkonnen. Let's see. This is a difficult spot to sit in against both of this. Shao's a little late to the party. No chance for retreat now. Good looks, Dan. Oh, sorry, I'm distracted with text messages. Okay, I gotta. All right, that was a really good defense from Kip, considering the situation he was in. He was moving units back, as you should. I just wasn't talking about it. Heavy weapons or vehicles. Bottom team's a little behind for sure. But still, give or take, has map control. Ooh, I hope Shao's looking at the mini map here, because if Dan here starts the fight, he won't be able to run. His devs will trail behind, and his tanks and missile tanks would pick them off. But look at that, it's gonna be two groups against one, and he's probably gonna lose all this shit. These units are too far behind. Kip's making some moves. Looks like he got himself a little force here. Divide and conquer at its best. Look at that. Sorry, guys. Fucking these texts are really intense right now. Hold on. Shave that. Okay, let's talk. Kip with his rotations, man. Pretty good. Pretty good. It's hard to keep up. Dan losing this fucking base is absolutely nuts. This guy's on three heavy. Well, he had four last time I looked at his base. Now he has two. Which is assuming the airstrike killed one, but fucking killed two out here. Two heavy, like two light, three light, whatever. Two racks, nothing crazy. He still has money, so that's pretty good. But Shao's been pretty uncontested in the advance on the right side. So it's pretty hard to defend. It's pretty hard to defend since like he doesn't have to micro at home. He could just build and push, which is pretty easy to do with Hark. That's like what it's good for. Arma has been stepping up, I must say. He's been doing pretty good. This is good micro. You don't just A click all your shit into the fucking army, into the Atreides army specifically. You get just barely into range and have the devs kill the Sonic tanks. And then after the Sonics are dead, you bring in the fucking rest. Quite an interesting game. I haven't been paying that much attention, but I hope the viewership is better, is a better experience. I feel worried about Dan though. He doesn't quite have an army to defend himself. Shao's just gathering shit. Good luck, Dan. You know what? Dan has enough here. He might be able to. Oh fuck, he's pulling all the halves. Okay, hold up. Equation has shifted once again. Oh, Arma's here. Let's go. Okay, how is he gonna address the situation at home? Because he's going to get rotated on pretty hard here. He's splitting his group, he's splitting his army. And that's quite the force. However, if he attacks here, I really hope he fucking doesn't, because that's a terrible fucking angle. Good. Yeah, you need to back up. That is not an attacking angle. Yeah, you need to get a bunch of shit here and then push up. Make him shift. Dan's doing exactly what he's supposed to be doing, backing up. However, he can't back up forever. He's going to get split if he backs up more than this, and dividing and conquering is what's going to destroy him. So, this is a really good engage on Shao's part because he got Dan in a terrible spot, terrible position here. And Dan's going to have to step up here. No, actually, I don't even know how to get out of this. This is scatter guard. Holy shit. Arma killed both of fucking oh no. He rotated back. Arma had sacrificed the second base to send his army over here. But is it too little too late? Fuck. That's the struggle with being so split on the top. You can easily get rotated on, and it's really hard to compensate Especially if you're Hark and your army's straight devs, because shit don't move, my guy. So that's one of the weaknesses, and goddamn, it's being exploited here. Oh boy. Guys, take notes. This is exactly the way you're supposed to use Harves. Use Harves and engage at the same time, and not just from across the fucking area. When your units are just out of range, that's when you're supposed to engage with Harves. Like that's the only way to make the use. Like how else? I've seen so many people just throw in Harves that are in Atreides' army and they just all die. Meanwhile, you're still like in your base, just pouring out of your base, single file line. You know, there's no opportunity there. You're just wasting Harves. Harves have so much potential, but nobody uses them as they're supposed to. But as you saw here, you throw them at the other army just as you're about to engage. More shit for them to shoot at the same time. Makes it so they shoot at your army less and they shoot at your Harves more, right? But if you send the Harves in first, they're using like all that time that you're not attacking their army is time that they're getting free hits off on your Harves, which is free hits on your shit is a bad equation for you regardless. Man, Dan has been. Yeah, that was a good try. Good game. Good game. Yeah, what's the fucking surprise? Ain't nobody fucking surprised. God damn it.